desert is the most populated desert on the planet. So having regenerative systems, water harvesting systems, sustainable food systems is as important in this region as it is in anywhere else on the planet. So let's take a look and see the water harvesting systems of Rajasthan.
The whole watershed.
Yeah, whole watershed.
Yeah.
This is a very good watershed.
Yeah. So prior to 2005, this was not farmed during the winter time, and it's really because of their watershed scale water harvesting structures that this is now farmed.
Each watershed in this region is seen as a single design unit, this one being over 8.5 square miles or 22 square kilometers large. The top is rocky and is used seasonally for communal grazing. Within the rocky slopes, they've built water catchment basins and fill seasonally and provide a slow percolation of water into the water table.
And now people use monsoon time this water for animals.
Okay.
Animals can use this water.
Yeah.
Because they graze in the top surrounding this hilly area. So 6 to 7 months water hold here.
We find larger storages of water at the base of these rocky slopes. On-contour berms stretch out from these ponds, collecting and diverting runoff from 110 acres of land in the case of this pond.
Bare rock hitting these diversion drains. These are the arms of the pond, these berms.
So we not use any type of machinery to build this structure. So this is the man-made structure on contour basis, built by the villagers. And you see a lot of animals here, cows and sheep and goats and wild animals and wild birds, which is stay here long time. And you see a lot of vegetation, a lot of trees surrounding this pond because water is continuously stay here. So no need to migrate anywhere with their animals to searching water. We also constructing rainwater harvesting tankas. So rainwater harvesting tankas have water for 5 to 6 months, but after that empty. So they fill the pond water through camel cart or tractor tankers when the tank empty. So this water also people use for drinking purpose or for domestic purpose in the household level.
Along the entire base of the rocky slopes, an on-contour wall divides the fields and acts as a stormwater slowing structure.
So water come here.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And go in the field.
Right. Yeah.
So this is the unique traditional technology which we use to allow water downside.
And it's coming from, because when it's coming off of this rocky hillside, it's just pouring down.
No soil erosion.
Right. So prior, right. So,
so cultivation land increase, not disturbing by the flash flood.
Okay.
During heavy rain.
So it's hitting, well, this wall looks like it probably is slowing down the water. And then there's another berm down below the wall, looks like an on-contour swale that then overflows, and you've channelized the overflow because previously in a flash flood, the water was just blasting through this whole field and causing a lot of soil erosion.
Once the water enters the fields in the valley bottom, it's further slowed and infiltrated because each field boundary is a water harvesting structure. Where there is a wide sandy wash, check dams intercept storm flow and spread flash flood waters out into the fields. There are techniques to manage overflow from one field to the next, as well as back flooding fields to avoid erosion. And at the very bottom of the drainage system, a large berm keeps water and soil from exiting the watershed and soaks the water into the water table.
So now you see, this is the almost 4 to 5 feet in between the down.
Yeah.
This is the up.
Right.
Earlier, when the structure built, this is the same. So you see how much soil we stopped.
When you add up all of the water over 8.5 square miles being sunk into the ground to recharge the aquifer, the result is that there's now enough groundwater to grow winter dry season crops, where before there wasn't.
Recharge the underground water. So this catchment is huge catchment, and huge water is coming, but no going waste. With all water used to increase subsurface or underground water, recharging, natural way.
Yeah, this is the impact of water harvesting. As you have fodder, water, and you can have cows.
This is just one watershed in one village. This same or similar design pattern has been implemented by Gravis in over 1,200 villages in 4 districts within Rajasthan, comprising 1.3 million people. Just take a minute and let this soak in. The scale of the collective impact that tens of thousands of small-scale structures and connections has on the abundance and resilience of the region.